guitars, red cigars, a long lost dream that I always can't do. I realize it changes with the fires in the skies. Look how we come. WAM's basically a membership-based non-profit incorporated association. It's been going for some 13 years. Its mission and charter in a sentence is to promote the growth and development of original contemporary music from WA. So anything that we can do to pursue that sort of mission statement, we do.
WAM exists, and so, you know, if you're playing local music, then you really have to be a part of it in some way.
The local music scene at the moment is thriving, let's face it. You know, you've got the Whammies coming up. There's an overall sense of excitement imbuing the place.
The Whammies is always good every year. I mean, there's heaps of bitching going on in the internet slag rooms, and but the Whammies are a good thing, whether bands get left out or not. It draws attention to WA. The whole of Australia recognises WA at least for 2 weeks a year when the Whammies are on. It's better than nothing.
We do get a lot of flack about, you know, bands not getting on the gigs or not getting on the CD, but it's almost in a way like a reverse compliment. We must be doing something right because they're really pissed off that they're not on it.
Bands that get, you know, don't get enough Whammy shows or whatever complain about, I suppose, aren't doing the hard yards or something, you know, I'm not too sure. But...
WAM's an interesting thing. Always found it interesting. I think because we sort of don't fit in, I don't think we do anyway, with what's typical of the Perth sound, we've always had the trouble with WAM.
People really sort of arc up, and if they don't like get a gig they wanted, or if they don't get nominated, or if they don't, you know, get the publicity they think they deserve, then it's time to bag everyone else who got three or four shows in the WAM calendar.
Yeah, I think it's good to recognise some people, even though it's all about having fun, and some people may complain about missing out, but it's all about just having a week or two of celebrating WA music, just sort of reminding everyone how good it is.
Everything I've heard from West Australia is very artistic and beautiful. I love it. I love it.
In the end, nobody will blame you. 'Cause in the end, there is nobody.
You know, seen lots of good stuff, and I think that Perth on the whole produces a very high quality amount of music per capita. Because a lot of good bands come from here, despite the population being kind of out of kilter with others. You know, they kind of produce maybe the same amount of bands as us. Billions of the buggers over there, they brood like rabbits.
In WA, we're so isolated over here. I mean, you can go over to the east and you can go to Sydney and Brisbane and Melbourne and everywhere. And there's just a broader range of people, so there's more of a chance of making a living out of it. Plus there's more of a, you know, there's more opportunities to play every night of the week, and which you don't get in Perth.
I don't think you can really... The record labels aren't interested in Perth bands. Like, they're interested in the music that they play, but it's, from what I've heard, it's too expensive to sign a Perth band because we're so out there from the East Coast. It's too expensive to tour.
I think there's always a rivalry between bands, and whether that's talked up more than it actually is, I don't know, but you know, that's just one of the things when you're in a close knit, especially in Perth, because all the bands know each other. You know, there's always that rivalry between them.
Like, I've never understood that myself, the whole competition with them Perth bands. Like, I guess getting a gig, yeah, like some people want to get a gig, someone else will get it, that might piss someone off.
We'd prefer if people left us out of their petty bitching, basically.
There's some very underrated bands that don't get people to see them, and there's some very sort of well-rated bands that pull a good crowd that possibly shouldn't.
unless you're prepared to step on a few toes and lick a few asses, then, you know.
It's kind of bitchy. I suppose it's a slight competitive edge.
Well, the thing is, like, I mean, we started predominantly punk gigs, so it's, you know, always at these sort of, you know, crappy pubs in the middle of nowhere and that sort of thing. So yeah, as soon as you get a few gigs at places like, you know, Grosvenor and Amplifier and stuff like that, there's more popular venues. The people that sort of used to come and see you at the, you know, the punk gigs take it as, I don't know, you've changed or something, which I find ridiculous because we certainly haven't gotten anywhere.
Wow, that's a good J airplay. You're okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I think there was a lot of talk, like maybe 12 months ago, that things were in a bit of a dip, probably because it seemed like venues were closing and we're running out of places for bands to play.
Yeah, because there's a lot of bands that don't get any recognition. There's so many bands and there's a few venues. So.
The venues are, you know, slowly declining and there's not enough people going out to see original music.
It's a healthy number of bands, but an unhealthy number of people actually going to see bands.
Punter attendance, I think, is absolutely fucking shithouse.
There is a lack of venues, for sure, in Perth, but more opening up. There's some classy venues in Perth, like Grosvenor, as always, an Amplifier and six others.
Like, everyone's trying to get onto the whole web thing. I mean, it's just another medium, just like Express and just like Channel 31 and... You know what I mean?
I mean, the most aggressive part of the Perth music scene is on the internet guest books and the local music websites, I think, and I guess that can be kind of bitchy, but it's better than people, you know, getting into fisticuffs at the Grosvenor front room or something.
The people that take it seriously are the losers, because if I go on and I'm just, you know, bored or something. And...
The whole aspect of the guest book is, if there's nothing controversial happening, someone makes something up.
Anonymous person writing in and just going, oh, you're fucked.
But yeah. No one says Jack hit to your face.
Yeah, I think bands like in Perth are struggling all the time, and then they see bands getting radio play and touring Australia, and they're a bit jealous of that fact. I don't think there's any need for it though.
It's a bit soul destroying when you think that you've really tried so hard to get to a certain level, and then you think that you do deserve some sort of recognition or some, I mean, not praise, but like, and you come back and the crowd's fewer than what they were when you first started, you know?
That's, I think, a good thing about the band, you know, it's, no one really cares about anything, it's just go for it. We don't really mind what people say. I think we're in the league now where it's, we have to compare ourselves to bigger bands, you know, like there's only so long you can ride on comparing yourself to mediocrity, you know.
Thank you.
Start making money, and then it's year enough for both.
We do want to make money though. We do want to be famous because we're on the dole, and it sucks.
And I think you have to be pretty serious to make it these days.
It's a good song, man. If it hits you in the soul.
Supposed to look at you now when there's two people.
Yeah, no.
Because I think if I look at you, the viewers will sort of look at you. So next time I answer, like now, you should be looking at me.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Chris. We're trying to make a documentary.